Amnesty International also calling for the immediate release of Senator De Lima. The rights group says Kerwin Espinosa's retraction only proves that De Lima is a victim of political persecution who has been singled out by the Duterte administration for her work as a human rights defender and legislator. AI Philippines asserts De Lima should have never been jailed in the first place, adding those who are behind the so-called trumped-up cases should be held liable.
A self-confessed drug lord recants his accusations against detained Philippine Senator Laila De Lima, saying he was only pressured to implicate the lawmaker in the narcotics trade. More in this report.
Self-confessed drug lord Kerwin Espinosa was touted as one of the government's strongest witnesses against now-detained Senator Laila De Lima. Arrested in Abu Dhabi to much fanfare, he testified in the Senate in November and December 2016 about his supposed exploits with the senator, how he supposedly gave a total of 8 million pesos in drug payoffs to De Lima when she was still Justice Secretary through her bodyguard, Ronnie Dayan. More than 5 years later, Espinosa is taking back all his claims. In a counter-affidavit submitted to the Justice Department Thursday, Espinosa said all of his statements against De Lima during the Senate hearing or included in his sworn statements are not true. He categorically said he had no dealings with the senator, nor has he given her any money at any given time. He also said the false statements were a result of pressure, coercion, intimidation, and serious threats to his family and family members from the police, who allegedly instructed him to implicate De Lima. He went on to invoke the death of his father inside a jail cell in Albuera, Leyte on November 5, 2016 as among the reasons he invented the allegations. Mayor Rolando Espinosa Sr. was one of the narco-politicians tagged by President Duterte. He was shot dead, supposedly during a service of search warrant. For all his allegations, Espinosa apologized to De Lima. Espinosa submitted the counter-affidavit in response to a drug complaint filed against him by the National Bureau of Investigation based on his confessions before the Senate in 2016. His lawyer, Raymond Palad, attributes Espinosa's recantation to his removal from the Witness Protection Program, among other factors.
Nagugat to nung alisin na siya, i-request ng NBI sa DOJ na alisin na siya sa Witness Protection Program. And yung pagpayag ng DOJ na alisin siya sa WPP at yung pag-alis sa kanya sa custody ng NBI. Ayan ang isang nakikita kong factor. And then pangalawa, kahit naman considered siya na state witness, no, under WPP, kahit minsan hindi siya ginamit as state witness, kapalit nung pag-discharge nung kaso sa kanya.
Various lawmakers and politicians called for De Lima's immediate release, including Vice Presidential candidate Walden Bello, calling De Lima a long-suffering victim of a frame-up based on President Rodrigo Duterte's vindictiveness. De Lima was among the vocal critics who initiated a Senate probe on Duterte's drug war. She has been detained for 5 years since her 2017 arrest on drug charges. But government lawyers were quick to downplay the latest twist in this half-a-decade-long saga. Prosecutor General Benedicto Malcontento said in a text message, this won't affect the two pending drug cases against De Lima since Espinosa was not used as a witness. A Muntinlupa court last year junked one of three drug cases against De Lima. Despite this, De Lima's lawyers are optimistic Espinosa's recantation will somehow influence the outcome of her pending cases.
But for us, this will now lay the pattern that many of the witnesses have been fabricating evidence and in fact being coerced only by the administration to cite these allegations against Senator Laila De Lima. We really hope now that all the witnesses will now master the same courage of Kerwin Espinosa, and we expect that soon justice and truth will prevail.
De Lima's camp is now considering filing countercharges against those who coerced Espinosa into linking her in the illegal drug trade. Her camp also believes the nearing end to President Rodrigo Duterte's term is one of the reasons why Espinosa has recanted his statements. In other news, the 22 fishermen of Philippine fishing vessel Gemver will finally be compensated nearly 3 years after their boat was rammed by a Chinese vessel. Philippine Justice Secretary Minado Guevara confirms the final settlement of damage claims between the two vessels has been reached, but the owner of Gemver will only receive 6 million pesos, or half of the estimated civil damages. The fishermen will be compensated as well. Back in June 2019, the Gemver boat was anchored in Reed Bank in the West Philippine Sea, but it was rammed by a Chinese vessel, causing it to sink. The Chinese vessel abandoned the Filipino fishermen following the collision, but they were later rescued by a Vietnamese vessel. Manila lodged diplomatic protests, but Beijing dismissed it as an ordinary maritime incident.